Welcome to Cyberworld YT. Like and subscribe if you are new here. Also, follow me on Instagram for more educational content. Link is in the description. Ever wondered what the top security risks to web applications are? Well, you're about to find out the realm of OWASP, the Open Web Application Security Project. This international non-profit organization is on a mission to enhance web application security worldwide. One of their crowning achievements is the OWASP Top 10, a document that outlines the most critical security risks to web applications. Think of it as a roadmap, guiding us through the treacherous landscape of cybersecurity. This list isn't just a theoretical exercise. It's drawn from data contributed by security firms and other organizations, providing a real-world snapshot of the battleground we face daily in the digital world. From broken access control to server-side request forgery, we'll be exploring each of these risks in detail, shedding light on their implications and how to combat them effectively. So, strap in and prepare for a journey into the heart of web application security. Let's delve into these risks one by one. Topping the list is broken access control. This risk involves situations where restrictions on what authenticated users are allowed to do are not properly enforced. Attackers can exploit these flaws to access unauthorized functionality and data, such as accessing other users' accounts, viewing sensitive files, modifying other users' data, or even changing access rights. The key to mitigating this risk lies in denying, by default, implementing a least privilege policy, and ensuring that access control checks are performed at every function that accesses a data source. Next, we have cryptographic failures, formerly known as sensitive data exposure. This risk focuses on the improper handling and protection of sensitive data. When an application does not adequately protect sensitive information, attackers can steal or modify weakly protected data to conduct credit card fraud, identity theft, or other crimes. To mitigate this risk, classify data processed, stored, or transmitted by an application. Identify which data is sensitive according to privacy laws, regulatory requirements, or business needs, and apply controls as per the classification. Finally, at third place, we have injection. Injection flaws occur when untrusted data is sent to an interpreter as part of a command or query. The attacker's hostile data can trick the interpreter into executing unintended commands or accessing unauthorized data. This includes flaws such as SQL, NoSQL, OS, and LDAP injection. To prevent injection flaws, you need to keep data separate from commands and queries. Use a safe API, which provides a parameterized interface, or migrate to use object relational mapping tools, ORAMs. These are just the first three of the top risks, but there's more to discuss. Moving on to the fourth risk, we have insecure design. This is a fresh addition to the list, focusing on design flaws that make your applications vulnerable to attacks. Think of it as building a house with a weak foundation. No matter how secure the locks on your doors might be, if the foundation is shaky, the whole structure is at risk. To mitigate this, you need to involve security considerations right from the design phase of your project. Next, we come to security misconfiguration, which has climbed up from the sixth spot. This involves improperly configured security settings, leading to potential unauthorized access to sensitive information. It's like leaving your house keys under the doormat. You might think it's a safe spot, but it's actually an open invitation for burglars. To prevent this, make sure you have a strong and thorough configuration process in place, and regularly review and update your security settings. Finally, we have vulnerable and outdated components, previously known as using components with known vulnerabilities. This risk has also moved up from the ninth position. It involves using outdated software components that are not updated or patched, leaving them vulnerable to exploitation. Imagine driving a car with worn-out tires. It might still move, but there's a high risk of a blowout. The best way to mitigate this risk is to regularly update and patch your software components and replace any that are no longer supported by the vendor. In the world of cybersecurity, knowledge is power. Knowing these risks and how to mitigate them can help you protect your web applications from potential threats. But remember, this is just the tip of the iceberg. There's a lot more to learn and understand about cybersecurity. We're more than halfway through the list. Let's continue to the final four. At number seven, we have identification and authentication failures. This is an evolved category from the previous broken authentication. The focus is now shifted to include a wider range of issues, such as mismanaged credentials and inadequate session management. As always, multi-factor authentication and robust password policies are your best friends here. Next up, at the eighth spot, we encounter software and data integrity failures. This new category for 2021 zeroes in on the lack of effective integrity controls. To counter this, one should always validate and sanitize all inputs and outputs, and regularly update and patch systems. At number 9, we have security logging and monitoring failures. This calls out the lack of logging and ineffective integration with incident response. A strong defense here involves comprehensive logging and effective incident response planning. Lastly, we have a new entry at number 10, server-side request forgery, or SSRF. This allows an attacker to cause the server to make a network request to an arbitrary URL, potentially leading to serious consequences. Mitigation strategies include whitelisting safe IPs and URLs, and blocking outgoing connections from the server to the internet. And there you have it, the OWASP Top 10. These are critical risks that all web developers and security enthusiasts should be well aware of. Remember, a secure web is a collective responsibility. Stay vigilant and keep coding securely. Understanding and addressing these risks is just the first step towards more secure coding. To recap, the OWASP Top 10, from broken access control to server-side request forgery, shines a spotlight on the most critical security risks for web applications. Armed with this knowledge, we can better anticipate, prevent, and mitigate these threats, contributing to a safer digital landscape. Stay tuned to CyberWorld YT for more insights into the world of cybersecurity. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.